Hi, my name is Cassandra Proust, and I'm a therapeutic yoga teacher. I teach a lot of classes to people with mobility issues, seniors, injuries, all sorts of things. In this particular video, we're going to do some things around balance, training your balance, and waking up some of the muscles that will help you feel stronger and more confident through your day. So we're going to start by waking up the feet a little bit. If you've got any sort of ball, a tennis ball or a bouncy ball, you can take that or any of those foot rollers, the sort of longer, narrower ones. You can bring that underneath your foot and just kind of waking up the sole of your foot. So you find how much pressure makes sense for you. And kind of roll back and forth, go side to side, maybe even shift so your weight, you're pressing down onto that ball for a few moments. But again, nothing so hard that it feels painful. And if you don't have a ball or anything like that, you can even take your feet kind of on top of each other and just sort of rub your feet together. Maybe take your toes underneath the sole of your foot. I lost my ball. And whether or not you've got the ball underneath your foot, or your feet are underneath your foot, you can also take one heel on top of the other. So maybe you stick the ball underneath and you take your heel and do like a little twirly twirl back and forth. Kind of wake up the top of your foot a little bit with your heel. You can do this wearing socks, even if you're wearing shoes, if you've got indoor shoes that you like to wear, you can keep those on and just put a little pressure to the top of the foot. We'll do the other side. So another option is if you're rolling, if you've got access to sort of bringing your foot actually up onto your knee and giving your foot a little massage, getting all your different toes, that's also a nice option. Just not everyone has access to their feet in this way. So you decide what makes the most sense. A little foot massage with your hands, a little foot massage with the floor and your feet. You can bring also the top of the heel again, sorry, the heel to the top of the foot. A little wake up of that. Just trying to wake up the nerve endings in those feet and get them to respond to us as we start doing some of the other things. I just wanted to balance out. I felt very crooked there. So I'm just taking those few moments to do that, and then we'll set the ball aside if we've got it somewhere out of the way. And we're going to come right back into the back of our chair here. So I'm going to do some ankle mobility exercises and some strengthening around our calves and our shins. And so if you are feeling strong through the thighs, you can hold up the leg with the strength of your leg. If your leg's not feeling so great, at any point through this ankle work, you can just leave the heel on the ground and do it like that. Or you can bring a pillow or something to give yourself a little bit of height for underneath the heel. So lots of options. I'm gonna show with the leg lifted up. So I'm gonna start with one of your legs. I've got my left leg up here, and I'm going to start with a simple flex and point. So I'm going to strongly flex my ankle. I'm going to strongly point my toes and go back and forth a couple times. And as you do that, you're really trying not to bend through your knee. So sometimes when we point, we want to bend the knee to make it look like we're going further. We just want to isolate through the ankle. Good. Then we're going to circle the ankle a couple times. So same thing here. We're trying to keep the knee as straight as possible. And we're trying not to let the whole leg rotate. So we're just circling the ankle and the toes. Might get some cracking like me. I'm gonna go a couple times in one direction, then we're gonna go the other way. Oh, I'm very cracky today. All right. So again, the knee is as stable as we can make it. And then we're gonna let that go. We're gonna slowly come down. I'm gonna try the other leg, same thing. So straight as you can through the knee, starting with the strong flex point. And as we do that, when we're holding the leg up with our leg's own strength, we're working on strengthening the thighs, which are a good muscle to help you stand up and down and to help you walk through your day. And we're going to start to circle the toes. And again, trying to isolate the movement in your ankle and foot so the leg isn't turning and the knee isn't bending. As round a circle as you can, and then we'll go the other way a couple times. And after that last one, you can bring that foot down. And we're going to come back to the first leg. So if the leg's starting to get tired, again, you can bring the cushioning underneath your foot. I'm going to keep lifting it up just so you can see them clearly. going to come here now and break down our foot a little bit. So we start with a nice strong flex. And you're just going to curl your toes like you wanted to trap a pencil. Then you're going to release the toes. You're going to do that a couple times. Just the toes curl. And then you release. Then we're going to add the ankle. So start with curling the toes. Now keep the toes curled. Now let the ankle point. Now we're going to keep those toes curled again. Flex the ankle and then release your toes. So four parts. We're going to curl. I'm going to point the ankle. I'm going to bring just the ankle back. Toes stays curled. And then release. We're going to do that one more time. So sometimes it takes a little attention. They might not listen right away. Especially if this is the first time you're doing it. And then again, toes release. Now we're going to go the opposite way. So let's start with the point, just for simplicity here. So we start with the point. Now again, just our toes are going to move. We're going to try and flex just the toes up. Try and keep your ankle exactly where it is. And just the toes are moving. And then we come down. Now the toes are going to move like we're wearing a high heel shoe. We're going to bring the toes back. And then toes stay behind, high heel shoe, and point your toes. More time. Again, just the toes come back, then the whole ankle, and then halfway, and then we add our toes again. Good. Now one last thing here. We're going to try and spread our toes wide, and we're going to try and squeeze our toes together. A couple times like that, spreading them wide and squeezing together. Legs probably getting pretty warm. One more. Spread them wide and squeeze together, and we'll bring that leg down. Thank you, leg. I'm going to try the other side. So again, start with a strong flex. We're going to do just the toes first. So try and just move the toes and then release. Like you're trying to trap a pencil with your toes. Again, it might take some encouragement. And again, the toes curl. Now we're going to add our ankle so the ankle goes. And then just the ankle flexes and then we release our toes. Again, we curl just the toes. We do our ankle. And the ankle comes back. And we release our toes. Now we're going to go opposite way. So go right to the point to start. Again, just our toes are going to come up. So like we're putting on a high heel shoe. And then point. Two more. Just like that. And point. One more. Just the toes are going to come up. And point. Now again, just the toes come. And we're going to add our ankle. We're flexing. Toes stay behind. Back to the high heel shoe. And point. Two more. Just the toes. Flex the ankle, toes stay behind, and add your toes. One more, just the toes, your ankle goes, toes stay behind, and add your toes. We're going to do the spreading wide of your toes, and you're going to try and squeeze them together. Again, try and spread them wide, you're going to squeeze them together, and one more time, spread them wide, squeeze together, and I'm going to let that leg come down. Thank you, guys. All right. So we're going to start to come up here towards standing for a few things. So if you've done this next exercise before, you can always bring a pillow between your knees. I'll show it without the pillow, and then I'll do one or two with the pillow. So we're going to come towards the front of the chair. We're going to do some bum hovers. So we're going to bring our feet underneath ourselves a little closer to the chair. So we're not going right underneath the chair. It's going to make our life harder. Bring it right towards the chair. Option one, we're going to keep the hands on the chair. Option two, our hands are going to come to your thighs. So you decide where you're going to start. I'm going to start with my hands here. I'm going to inhale tall. And as I exhale, I'm going to lean my shoulders forward. I'm going to press my feet down. Maybe my bum can hover off the chair. If it's not going anywhere, you're just going to keep pressing those feet down so the thighs start to work. We're going to slowly come down and then inhale, come up. I'm going to do that a couple times. Again, leaning forward, exhale. Inhale, press the feet down, slowly coming down, and then body comes up. So if that's working with the hands down, you can bring them to your thighs. Exhale. Inhale, hover your bum. Or imagine hovering your bum. Visualize that as you exhale, bum is lowering. As you inhale, we're coming up. You can do three more. Exhale. Inhale, nice long spine. Keep pressing those feet, whether or not your bum is actually lifting off of the chair. Now I'm going to do two more here. I'm going to show you what it might look like. I have a giant pillow, but you know, a smaller pillow. But you can hug it together between your knees. Same thing. We'll inhale tall. As we exhale, we lean forward, press those feet down. Maybe the bum hovers. Try and keep squeezing onto the block. Slowly lower your bum down. Inhaling up, one last one. Exhale, leaning forward. Try and not lift from your shoulders here. Notice if your legs are doing it. Slowly come down. Inhaling up. Last time here, we're going to come all the way to standing. Press those feet down again. Try and lift from the legs, not from the shoulders. And then we're going to come all the way to standing. If you're using that pillow, you're going to take it out of the way. Phew, thank you, legs. All right. So we're going to come to behind the chair now. And so you can hold onto your chair with both hands. You should be able to see my feet, actually. So, all right, I'll stay here. We're going to start by waking up the soles of our feet a little bit more. So you're going to start to lift one heel as high as you can. Slowly bring the heel down, and then the other heel will lift and down. A couple more times, right foot. That's my left foot. And the other side. What we're going to do is we're going to try and wake up the muscles in the sole of the foot here. We're going to do a little action. I'm going to turn to the side so you can see me. So I'm going to bring one toe like I'm wearing a high heel shoe. And then I'm going to almost imagine like I'm striking a match with my toes. I want to see how fast I can curl them under. So I'm going to curl my toes. And then I'm going to let my foot come back to that high heel shoe position. Again, trying to curl the toes under. And bring that back to the high heel shoe. We're going to do four of those. Curl the toes under as fast as you can, like you're lighting a match. And if you're nice and quiet, you might actually hear your toes go. And then bring that down. Actually, let's do two more. Okay, curl as fast as you can. And down. One more time. And under. And all the way down. Good. We're going to try the other foot. A couple times. We're going to try and curl those toes under as fast as we can. And down. Again, like that. We're curling, we're lighting a match, or like we're almost a horse. I've seen horses do this. Four more times. We're going to curl and down. Three more times. We're curling. We're coming down. Two more. Curl and down. And one more. Curl and down. Beautiful. Okay, we'll bring the feet back together. So that engagement's going to help us in a little moment. We'll do some weight shifting. But for now, come to using both feet here. And we're going to bend our knees, both of our knees. We're going to keep our knees bent. We're going to start to lift through our heels. So strong thighs here. We're going to straighten up through the legs. Strong ankles. And then we're going to slowly lower down. Strong calves. So we're bending our knees. We can inhale. We can exhale, lift our heels. I'm going to inhale, straighten the legs. We're going to exhale, lower the heels. Couple more times. Inhale, bend the knees. And exhale, lift our heels. Inhale, straightening the legs. And exhale, lower the heels. And do one more time. Inhale, bend. Exhale, lift. Inhale, straight legs. And exhale, lower our heels. Now we're going to go the other way around. If you're getting tired, you can take a break. You can always pause this video, come back to it. Or just do parts of the video. If you feel still strong enough to do the other way, we're going to start up on our toes, inhaling. Now keep the ankles strong. Bend the knees, the heels are lifted. Inhale, heels lower, knees stay bent. Exhale, you're straightening your legs. Three more times, inhaling up. Exhale, knees bent, heels stay lifted. Inhale, heels come down. Exhale, we're straightening. Good, let's do two more. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more time, inhaling up. Exhale, bend the knees. Inhale, heels lower, knees stay bent. And exhale, straighten. Awesome. Now if you want to shake those feet out a little or circle your ankles. So there we were strengthening calves, thighs, ankles, all sorts of things to help us when we start to go through our days. It's a great exercise to do as well if you've ever got swelling through the ankles or through your feet, as well as all those foot things we were doing in the chair a moment ago. When the calves are nice and strong, all our circulation, our blood, if it pulls down in our feet, if we think that's the closest thing to the floor, the heaviest for gravity, So if we want the blood to pump back up to the heart, we can do lots of stuff here for our ankles, for our calves to help the blood come back up. So we're now going to come to another muscle group, sort of the sides of our bum, that is a good strong muscle to help us with our balance through our day and as we travel, through our days, I should say. So we're going to come to have both hands here on the chair, and we're going to find that when we were doing that light match lighting a moment ago, we're going to think about that when we're doing this. So we're going to reach our toes to the one side, and as you shift your weight and step onto your foot, you're going to bend that knee. Now here, try not to lift just with your thigh. Imagine your feet are working with you. You're going to press strongly and then bring your feet together. You're going to do six on this side, so you're going to reach your toes. As you step on the foot, you bend the knee and then press not just with your leg, but also with your foot, and slowly together. Four more times. We're reaching. You decide how big this lunge is going to be. Whatever makes sense. You press strongly and then you come together. Two more. I can never count to six. Okay, again, press, press, press. And together. So again, try not to leave your toes behind here. Your toes are a part of the process. We're pushing down to help us lift. So I'm going to show one what I mean, what I'm not looking for. So when you come through it, try not to land on a flat foot. And that's going to make your whole body shudder. It's going to hurt through the knees and even potentially up through the spine. So if you go through our foot, toes, and then the heel, and then the knee bends. And on the way up, we're doing the opposite. So you're pressing down strongly so the toes get left behind, as opposed to, can barely do it, lifting the toes with us. Okay, so we're going through, we're using our foot like a shock absorber. So we're going to come to the other side. The left leg is going to reach. And we're going to step again, toes, then heel, then knee. And you press strong and together. Five more. We're going to reach. I'm going to bend. I'm going to press strongly and together. So again, trying to use the foot on the way down like a shock absorber. On the way up like extra force. Press and together. Three more. Through the foot. And we're pressing. And together. Two more times. Now hopefully you're feeling some work through the sides of your bum. And as you go, as you get stronger, if you feel supported, you can maybe try one hand. Try and just do it with one hand. Even with no hands in certain moments. Together. Last one. Phew. Alright, thank you, legs. So our next thing we're going to do is a little bit of training for our balance. So we've been working on strengthening some of the muscles that are going to help you stand nice and tall and get through your day. But now we're going to actually focus on training our balance. So one way we're going to do that is by narrowing the amount of us that is connected to the floor. So you're going to, like you're standing on a balance beam or a tightrope, and try and bring one foot in front of the other. You're going to try and bring your weight equally on either of those feet. You're going to start simply trying to balance. So you'll see maybe one hand, maybe your fingertips, or no hands, and your ankles are going to do a fun ankle dance there, trying to keep you up, which is great. They're learning how to help keep you standing. And then if that's an easy one for you, you're going to try and close one eye. So either closing one eye just to close it, or if you need your hand to help to close it, and try and close that eye. Make sure you're breathing. And then if you've let go, you're going to take hold of the chair again. Bring the hand down if it's covering your eye. We're going to release. I'm going to switch sides. So first, we sort of shrink down the amount of space that we're taking on the floor. It's one way we're challenging our balance. And then as we start to test here, if we do decide to close one eye, our vision system is one system that really helps us to balance. So if we shut off one of those systems, our eye, if we close our eye, we're making our body work harder. We're making our inner ear work harder, our vestibular system. So one or two more breaths. And challenging those other parts of our body by turning off one of the systems that's helping us balance. And then we're going to bring the hands back down if they're lifted. We're going to bring our feet together. Now, there's so many versions of this exercise, you could totally stop there. I'm going to show you a couple other options. But again, we're always coming from that one foot in front of the other, like you're on a tightrope stance. So we have the option to close one eye or the other. You can close both eyes if you Another option we can do, and again, you're holding on as little or as much as you need. You can try and turn your head. So here we've got the inner ear that we're working, the vestibular system. So we're making that harder by turning the head. And then we're slowly coming back. My ankles are doing their ankle dance. We're coming back. And coming back together. Smiling helps amidst all of this. Good. We're going to switch feet. So we'll show you a different version with the head. Maybe we're shaking it like we're saying no. Or maybe we're letting one ear get heavy towards the shoulder. Like you've got a really heavy earring on and you bring the head up. Or like you're holding a phone between your ear and your shoulder. Again, that's for working the inner ear. You don't want to move too quickly. You're going to surprise your body. Good. And then we'll let that go. Now you can combine things there as well. So if you'd like, you've got the balance beam you're standing on. You turn your head and one eye's closed. Fancy, fancy stuff. All right, you can also consider, if you're extra good at this, I'm just giving you lots of options so I don't have to make another video in the future. If when you're doing that, you're turning your head, maybe you want to move one arm. And then as the arm comes down, the head comes around. Woo, that's extra hard. Lots of ways. So any arm movements you're doing, any head movements you're doing, any eye closing you're doing is going to challenge all those body systems. All right, that's our balance training. So if you've been standing long enough and you want to come to a seat for these next two, you can. But we can also do, I'll show both options. I'll show a seated option and a standing option. So our standing option for this next exercise is going to be, this is to strengthen the backs of the legs, the backs of the thighs, the hamstrings. So again, another one of those strong muscles, very important for your balance. And we'll stand here on one leg. I'm going to turn right to the side for this one. And what I'm going to look for you to do is to not let the knee move forward. You're going to try and slow motion, kick yourself in the bum. This is as far as I can get. I can't actually kick my bum, but that's the direction I'm going. And then I'm slow motion coming down. So what I'm not looking for is this, where the knee comes forward, and I'm not looking for fast forward. So the slower we go, the more we're asking that muscle to work, both on the way up and on the way down. And you can do about six or so on either leg. You can work your way up in numbers. And if you're not standing anymore and you've come to a seat again, you can bring your bum a little bit forwards. You're going to lean back in your chair. And if the chair is tall, you might have a support for your head. If it's not tall and you want to support your head, you can. You're going to stretch out one leg out in front of you. And what you're going to do is try and press your heel down into the floor as though you were trying to indent some sand. So really strongly press, and then you let your leg relax. So similar muscle group here. We're pressing the heel down. It doesn't look like anything. But I'm pressing my heel as strong as I can, and I feel the back of my leg turn on here when I do that. And then I let the leg relax. So same thing like with the bum kicks behind you. We can do six presses down or six bum kicks, and then I'll switch to the other leg. So now my other leg is long. I'll do a couple down here, and then I'll do a couple standing. Again, we're pressing the heel down. Strong, strong, strong as you can, and then you let it relax. Make sure you're breathing. Maybe you exhale when you press, and you inhale when you let it release. And I'll do one more here in the seat. Again, I'm pressing my leg strongly down. I feel that work in the back of my leg. And then I exhale, let it relax. And if I'm still standing and doing those bum kicks here, I'm trying not to let the knee tip forward. I'm trying to go just straight back. And slow motion on the way down. And if I'm starting to get tired and my body's not able to keep going, I can close my eyes and I can visualize my body doing this movement. And if I do that, I'm priming my neural pathway, so I'm priming my brain to be ready for this movement when my body's ready to do it. So my brain is learning even if my body isn't doing it just yet. That's always an option in any of these exercises. Now our last thing we're going to do, we're going to come to a little bit of a balance test step here, and I'll also do a seated version here if you're still down. So our standing balance test, we're going to have our right toes under the chair. We're going to tap our right knee towards the chair. So the front knee bends. The back leg's going to step back. Back leg back. And here, we're going to try and let our tailbone reach down towards the floor. You can't actually see my hands. We're trying to reach this down. And our head up towards the ceiling. We're going to notice if our shoulders are trying to hold ourselves up. If they are, we say, thank you, shoulders. But it's our legs' job now. And there's a little firmness in your belly. So what starts to happen if our tailbone goes back, if we have an arch in our low back, we might get some grumpiness here. So you reach your tailbone down, firm a little in your belly, and then maybe you test your balance. Okay, one hand, no hands, fingertips, breathing. All right, we'll stay for one more breath. Nice, strong front thigh. And out. Bring the hands down. We step our feet together. Now, if you're going to keep doing the standing, you're going to do that again. I'll show the other leg when I'm seated. So, less so about the balance here, more about the strengthening of the thigh that you get in that version. We're going to sit up as tall as we can. Here we get an additional belly workout. So we can sit as tall as we can. You can decide either your back right against the chair, or if you want your back a little more forwards, away from it. Just some different kinds of work. We're going to try and lift our thigh, our left thigh. So that's the leg. If you're behind, that's the thigh that's working. If this is really tiring and you can't actually lift the toes, we're trying not to get our body to go back. So even if it's just lifting your heel up, like you want to think about lifting the foot off the floor, that's great as well. You're going to still feel the work in the thigh. And then just like you might if you were standing, you can reach your fingers forward, maybe both. You're trying not to lift from here. Nice soft shoulders. Let's take one more breath. And out. And then we can let the leg come down, or we can come to standing if we were doing the standing version. And then we'll all take a nice little rest in a seat. So as you come to a seat, you can let your legs come somewhere, after all that work, somewhere that the muscles can relax over your bones, right down to your toes. So maybe give your toes a little wiggle, let your feet, your calves relax. See if you can signal with your mind to your thighs, your bum, that the chair is holding you up, so those can soften a little bit as well. And coming into your fingers, into your arms, all those muscles as well can relax over your bones, so much so that the shoulders get a little heavier. You can close your eyes here if that feels comfortable. Otherwise, soften them so you're not looking too clearly at me anymore. You can just listen as best you can. Then we can again signal to our torso that the back of the chair is holding you up. So your belly muscles, your back muscles can get a little softer. To travel right up into your whole face. And with your eyes closed or soft, can you let the forehead relax? Your cheek. Can you imagine behind the ears getting softer? And seeing if you can let your jaw really heavy. Your tongue is down by your bottom teeth. So there's nothing left to do here but rest. For another minute or so, let all that work sink into your body. Each exhale, letting things soften, both physically and mentally. A tiny bit more each breath. As we take a few last breaths here, we take a moment to thank ourselves for taking this time today to be strong, find moments of softness, to take this time for ourselves. You can stay here in this restful place as long as you might need. Whenever you feel you might be ready to come back to the room, starting by deepening your breath a little bit.
Ooh, maybe having a yawn.
And then bringing any small and larger movements back into your body. However you want to come back into the space. And slowly come back. So thank you so much for taking this time for yourself. Knowing that any work you're going to be doing around waking up the nerve endings in your feet, whether that's with your hands like we did at the beginning with the ball, any work you're doing to mobilize your ankle or find ways for those ankles to move, it's going to help you when you come up to standing, when you're walking. Any sort of weight shifting you're doing, if your ankles are very stiff and we're walking with a bit of a shuffle, if the ankles don't move, all of a sudden we have to move from our hips. And if we do fall, if something, if we do stumble in any way, then our hands or shoulders or whole upper body is going to take the brunt. If we can find the mobility in our ankle and that speed to step forward and to shift our weight and catch ourselves with the strength in our thighs, then we have sort of less worry about falling from this angle. So again, ankle movement, waking up the nerve endings in the feet, strength through the thighs for when you shift your weight, strength in the calves to help the blood move and to keep us strong when we're standing. Lots of great work in here to take with you, so good luck, enjoy, and if you've got any questions at all, feel free to send me an email. It's yogawithcassandra@gmail.com. You can message below here in the link.